Good morning, we're so glad you're here.
We daily vlog, so if you like this video, come on back tomorrow.
Today's an eventful day, kind of.
Kind of.
It's just been like all over the place. Like I slept in a little bit. I'm not doing a run today, I'm doing one of those ridiculous interval videos later.
I did my whole morning routine.
You did, and you're going to the doctor to listen to our baby's heartbeat.
Yeah, it's going to be a really quick appointment. It's just like my 16-week, even though I'm 17 weeks, so they had to push it back. But that means then we only have to wait 3 more weeks.
And hopefully I can go to that one because I can't go today.
No. So yeah, I'm going to leave soon. I think I'm going to make a little something for lunch. Let the vlog export, and hopefully, I mean, last time I waited a really long time. I'm assuming that's...
You bring a book just in case.
Yeah, I'm going to bring a book, but I can also get the vlog situated, so. Alrighty, I made grilled cheeses with a pickle for lunch, and now I'm getting the marinade situated to make our little mushroom tacos again. This time I'm following the recipe. I got all of the actual ingredients. They were really delicious last time. I'm hoping they're gonna be even better tonight, and we're gonna make more, which is a big deal because last time we only had enough for 4 tacos, and I want 10 tacos for myself. Okay, so I just reused the plastic that was on top of the mushrooms. These are going in the fridge until dinner time, so like 6 hours.
Does anybody else remember when there was supposed to be a World War Z 2, the movie? Yeah, I'm watching World War Z now as I work. I had a all-staff meeting earlier today, and I actually got to be the presenter for my team, so that was kind of fun. Sarah's at the doctor. In 7 minutes, Jeffree Star's new makeup palette releases, only on his website, so I'm nervous that it's going to crash or it's going to be super hard to get. But Sarah is not a big makeup person, and she really wants this palette, so it's my mission because it's part of her birthday, other part of her birthday present, that we're going to order that. So it's my duty to be right there on the dot at 1 p.m. Eastern, ready to go to snatch up that Jeffree Star new palette. So fingers crossed there. Here we go. 10 a.m. Pacific. This is tomorrow. This isn't today. This is today's the 21st. That's the 22nd. This is. Well, all right. Stress will begin tomorrow. Oops.
So I am already back. I didn't have to wait at all, which is awesome compared to last time. But they did my vitals, and I'm waiting for the doctor. Easy peasy appointment today.
Beautiful baby in there. So we're 120s to 160s is normal, and we're 130s and 40s. Exactly where we should be hearing it. And then 150s are showing off a little bit.
Alright, things got exciting after my goof on the date of when that palette was coming out, because I didn't realize, I knew Universal was going to do a presentation to the economic whatever task force back in Florida, for Central Florida, about their plans and how they plan on reopening the theme parks. I did not realize it was going to be live, and it starts in about a minute or two, so I'm going to pull that up on the TV and watch that while I work. I don't know how long it's gonna be.
I think I'm gonna join my friend's little live stream. You may remember some of my friends from when my UK visitors came last year, but I might hop in this.
I'm FaceTiming Christine and the kids, and Luca's never laughed like this. Violet's just throwing like little pebbles.
One, two, three, go!
So stinking cute!
Peter just finished doing like a live chat on YouTube with some of our UK friends. I'll let him explain it because I really wasn't involved because I was finishing up the vlog and FaceTiming Christina and now getting dinner started. And I just wanted to share what our side dish is to the mushroom tacos. And that is one of our favorite dishes that we have not had in forever. And I remembered it last night and decided we're going to make it today. And that is fideo, which is just kind of like a Mexican pasta dish, but I'll show you. Starts out with an onion, minced garlic, olive oil, and salt and pepper. Now that they're see-through, I can start adding in the other ingredients. The first one would be angel hair pasta. I only have fettuccine, so I'm gonna do that. But you throw the pasta uncooked right in the pan.
Doesn't Sarah just look so cute?
I got these from Amazon because Peter's mom got me a gift card for my birthday, and I got bunch of stuff.
But we really wanted the overalls because we were trying to find overalls. Hey, Evie's being super sweet. Okay. She keeps cracking these pastas and make them small and they keep flying.
Okay, everywhere. So listen, if you're going to make this, do it like little stacks by little stacks. I finally got a whole box in, 16 ounces, but then you have to like break it up and make it small. It's easier with angel hair pasta. But it's still fun.
Like angel hair pasta.
You like it with fideo though. See?
See?
Ah! So we're breaking it up.
You look like a country, like you're looking on a farm right now, especially with the bare feet. You look like a country bumpkin, yeah.
And then you cook this until you can start to smell it.
Are we going to Disney Springs tonight?
Who knows?
Are we going to Universal or City Walk tonight?
Who knows?
Oh! It's almost Friday and I have an early release tomorrow, so it feels extra like the weekend.
She's also, I had to hold her because she's just wanting to get all the pasta that drops.
I literally wrote this down probably right when Peter and I got married. So I made like a little vegan bouillon cube and then two cans of tomato juice, chopped tomatoes, and then cook until it bubbles and then just let the pasta cook. Here's how it looks, and then you just let the pasta soak up all the liquids.
You know Sarah's cooking a good dinner when you keep coughing in the air because there's like seasoning in the air. It is spunky, but it smells delicious. I want to say I had so much fun joining that live stream with some of our friends from the UK and Jackie from Super Enthused talking about the opening of Disney Springs and City Walk. And they, our friends from the UK have been doing that for a few weeks now. I think it's the 9th or 10th week that they've been doing it, I think. I'm not sure who is specifically...
In discussion,
yeah, of these live streams. They do like a different topic, and then they have like their set of voices that come on there in live stream discussion a topic, and they have some guest speakers. So we'll put a link down below of all the accounts that typically show up on it, and there's an actual, they have a dedicated YouTube that they do it, and it's every Saturday. I don't know what the UK time is, but did we say it's like, it's gotta be around this time, probably around 4 p.m. Eastern Standard Time here in the States. But it was a lot of fun. We'll put the links down below for the discussion channel and then everybody else who's involved in it. I hope I want to go back on there because it was a lot of fun talking and everything. So thank you everybody for letting me get on there and ramble because you guys know I love to talk all the time.
What would you do if you're drunken, sailor? What would you do if you're drunken, sailor? You lay on the ground yearning for some human to drop food. Don't you know by now that we don't drop food for you? She is just a good girl. All right, here we go. Looking delicious. Sarah's dishing us up three little tacos, little tacos.
This is a avocado crema. It's a basically just
Can you try to say that word again?
No, because I can't roll my R's.
An avocado
all.
Crema.
But I mix in some ranch dressing.
Are you salivating because you're so hungry? I could hear it. So Sarah's dishing us up and then we're going to manja. And then we're going to see what we're going to do. Tonight, if anything.
Word.
Maybe watch a movie and stay on the couch. Maybe we'll leave.
You never know.
You never know.
Oh, oh. Number two. We're trying to go to Springs.
But it looks like it's gonna sprinkle.
Sprinkle is one way of putting it.
It's like the strangest things, guys. Like we got in the car anticipating it being like a torrential downpour, but now like I keep seeing rain in the distance, but we never get there.
So are we just chasing it?
I don't know if we're chasing it or if it's chasing us.
Somehow it's looking good. So we found the rain, just a little sprinkle on our way in.
We're not even bringing umbrellas and we have two in the car.
So yeah, time to get our temperature checked before we go in.
You guys know the Brookhearts never stop, especially in rain. And that actually works to our advantage.
Yeah.
Because look at this beautiful Disney Springs right now.
Nobody's here.
And this time yesterday, we're here a little bit earlier than yesterday. There's a few hundred extra parking spots available.
Also, we came today compared to tomorrow because we figured like Friday, the first Friday it's open, it's gonna be a little bit crazy. So we just wanted to get a little bit extra time in. And now it's even better because it's even more empty.
All right, fingers crossed the patio is looking empty, but we are here.
Fun fact, the bar is actually closed here at Boathouse. You have to have a reservation, and they were kind of giving us a hard time because we couldn't find one online. Mm-hmm. Then another guest was like, just go in, after the hostess kind of said no. And I think the hostess
Was like, you have to like call or make a reservation, and another guest just kind of let us know. Like, we walked in, so he let us come in and just see if it was available, and we really wanted to sit out here tonight.
Which works out that it just got done raining.
Yeah, and so I think it slowed, like with the rain it slowed down, and that probably worked in our favor. But tonight we're celebrating how our appointment went really well today, and
next appointment, fingers crossed, I'll get to go.
Yeah, in 3 weeks. So we're gonna order maybe just some fries and some drinks and relax.
Enjoy
on
the
water.
Sarah got a, what'd you get?
It's just a mezcal mule with no vodka.
And they put some like crushed bitters on it. That's what the good thing about if they don't have non-alcoholic drinks on the menu and you're at like a location with an actual bar, they'll make these like custom ones, which like should be simple, and they're really good still because they're custom made like
and
a normal
fresh.
Mix. And fresh. And I got a beach hippie IPA. Look at that, looking really good. And then look at this right here. All to ourselves.
So we just took our masks off to enjoy our drinks and our little bit of eats we're gonna get.
Cool. It's good, it's very hoppy.
Oh.
But like not the kind of hoppy that I am the biggest fan of. It was just a little bit more bitter. But it's got a weird taste to it, but it's from Florida, it's from DeLand, Florida.
I'm sorry if you don't like it.
No, it'll be good.
Maybe it'll get better over time. Is that a thing?
It is the thing if you have lots of alcohol, I guess.
All right, so here's Sarah's mojito.
Really good. It's not a mojito, it's a mezcal mule. So I'm liking the amount because sometimes I'll get a mezcal mule and it's still in like the little cup. So it's nice because it's like the mojito size and super limey, but just has that ginger beer. It's really good.
Okay, so we only got this lens like a week before everything closed down.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm so pumped because it's like, feel like we haven't gotten to use it out and about as much.
And my hair is crazy.
And you look beautiful and like this just looks so good. They might move us in, they came out and warned us because I think there's a storm coming in.
But it just feels good for now.
Yeah. It looks like a little stormy action might be coming our way, but they turned on the lights and it is right. Like, look at the lights reflecting off the water. It's just gorgeous.
So I just got my second drink. It's a cranberry bubbly. That's all I asked for. So it looks good. There's a cherry in there.
I got a sailfish IPA from Fort Pierce, Florida. This one's supposed to be less hoppy, but the can does say 3 pounds of hops per barrel. So fingers crossed this is better than the last one because I wasn't a big fan of that one.
Gotta try to find out.
That's more my flavor.
Yeah?
Yeah.
So truly, we chose this location to come out and celebrate because of the view. But it is, again, so weird without my boats. Thanks for the ambiance. And then there's this cool boat. Looks like a rescue boat. And then there's four of the amphicars. Just waiting over there for their day to come.
Okay, this place is the best playlist.
It does.
All right, we're done here. It's 9:30. We're gonna run to the washroom and then walk around a little bit because it's gotta be super empty.
How's my hair?
Florida humidity hair is bad. I almost think like your hair isn't used to the humidity again.
Yeah.
So
and it's also longer.
Yes.
Like, my hair is really long.
Very long. But there's only 30 minutes before spring closes and it looks very empty. So we wanna just like nighttime peruse.
The music here has been awesome. And then they turned it up a notch too. Okay.
I love Elton John. Look at this. We're literally, there's two other people I see over there. That's it.
But it also is closing very soon.
Yeah.
And the rain, I'm sure.
The rain drove everybody away now that it's closing.
Nice.
This is so nice. Beautiful.
One of the biggest things we wanted to come and see at Disney Springs were the twinkling lights.
Tinkerbell did it.
She did.
One piece of comforting
fun. I'm gonna get an Instagram.
Oh, okay. One bit of comforting action that's happening here at Disney Springs that I just didn't show yesterday. My boy Stitch, experiment 626, spitting away. And all the guests. Ooh, it is good to be home.
Uh-oh. That's a little too late. Today is May 21st, Thursday. Ooh, it's a shorty. It's by Anonymous. There's no time to be bored in a world as beautiful as this. Ooh, I agreed. I'm gonna be honest. You might be able to tell from my hair. We have not been awake this whole time. I foolishly put on that movie at like 10:30 p.m. We probably could have and should have gone to bed right then and there, but I put on yesterday, and honestly, I think within 5 minutes, Sarah and I both fell asleep. So I just woke up after it ended, and so I'm gonna round everybody up. I'm gonna go to bed and get up and finish out this work week with a short Friday before the long holiday weekend. It's gonna be awesome. It's good to be home.
We know what our goals are. We know what we hope to accomplish. And believe me, it's the most exciting and challenging assignment we've ever tackled at Walt Disney Productions.